The OPCW has 193 member states that work together to rid the world of chemical weapons. But how do so many countries do that? How is the OPCW governed? Countries that commit to the Chemical Weapons Convention are both states parties to the convention and member states of the OPCW. Together, member states oversee and implement the articles of the convention through the 193 member conference of the state parties and the 41 member executive council. Both are supported by the technical secretariat. Before exploring the role and function of each body, let's talk about member states. Each member state names a permanent representative to the OPCW. When a new permanent representative arrives, they present their credentials to the OPCW Director General, demonstrating that they are their country's official representative. Member states are organized into regional groups: Africa, Asia, Eastern Europe, Latin America and the Caribbean, and Western Europe and other group. The groups facilitate the coordination of policy positions and help formulate consensus. Now, back to who does what in the OPCW. The Conference of the State Parties is the principal and plenary organ of the OPCW and includes all state parties. It meets in The Hague for 1 week every year. The conference oversees the implementation of the Chemical Weapons Convention, promotes its goals, and reviews compliance with the treaty. It also sets the strategic direction of the OPCW and the budget and program of the Technical Secretariat. If consensus decision-making is not possible, a vote is held, with each member state having one vote. There are no vetoes. A two-thirds majority of present and voting members is required for substantive matters. The Conference of the States Parties also provides an opportunity for civil society to share how they help uphold the Chemical Weapons Convention. The Executive Council is composed of 41 member states that are elected by the Conference of States Parties and rotate every 2 years. The Council meets in the IPA room at OPCW headquarters at least 3 times per year. It supervises the activities of the Technical Secretariat and is responsible for promoting the effective implementation of and compliance with the Convention. It makes recommendations to the Conference of the States Parties on specific actions that could be taken. The Executive Council also has considerable power in implementing the Convention without reference to the Conference of the States Parties. It can form agreements with state parties on assistance and protection against chemical weapons. It can also negotiate agreements for verification activities. The Technical Secretariat implements decisions taken by the Conference of the States Parties and the Executive Council and carries out functions assigned to it in the Chemical Weapons Convention. Led by the OPCW Director General, the Technical Secretariat has about 500 staff members recruited from over 80 OPCW member states. They are responsible for carrying out the Convention's verification measures, conducting on-site inspections, and providing technical assistance to member states. This assistance ranges from helping countries implement the Convention, to ensuring preparedness in case of a chemical attack, to promoting the peaceful use of chemistry. Learn more at opcw.org.